Today is going to mark a big change in the PC community because today is the day that Intel regains their leadership against AMD, and we are going to build a PC that is surely going to make this day memorable. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and today we have DDR5 memory, the latest Intel Z690 motherboard, and a hot new Intel Alder Lake CPU which we will check out the performance of. So let's see what kind of excitement awaits us. A special build demands for a special case, and for that we have the very fitting ROG Strix Helios VFBC, which stands for Very Big F***ing Case. ASUS really didn't hold back on anything when designing this, and I can tell you that this case is way more impressive in person, especially in this white version. The additions like single button releases for the dual tempered glass side panels and the carrying straps are some really useful additions that made our building experience very convenient. And this also looks like it will stare you to death if you don't put good things inside it, which is always appreciated. The PSU that this build deserves is the 1200 watt ROG Thor, which is just a perfect match for this case because the cutout on the PSU shroud will let us see the OLED screen and the RGB. It also comes in individually sleeved cables, which was something that I saw for the first time in a PSU. We are of course not going to compromise on our motherboard for this build, which is going to be the ROG Maximus Z690 Hero, and it really has all the latest generation of tech from PCIe Gen 5 to support for DDR5 RAM, and it also comes with some special add-ons inside. It even has two Thunderbolt ports, and I also really like its aesthetics, which are somehow bolder while also looking cleaner than before. We can see the big heat sinks covering its 12+1 teamed power phase delivery system, and it also has this very well thought out quick release button for its top PCIe slot, which will make removing your GPUs much easier and safer, and this really was long overdue in motherboards. The main highlight of this build is of course the new Intel Alder Lake 12900K with 16 cores and 24 threads, and everything about this CPU is quite different as we are finally on Intel's new 10nm process without any plus signs, and even though we have quite an unusual addition of efficiency cores on a desktop CPU for the first time, just hold on for a while before underestimating the power of this approach. We have 32GB of the newly released Gandewa DDR5 RGB RAM from the Indian brand Astra, which runs at 4800 megatransfers per second, and I have been using their SSDs and other stuff in my personal PC, so I am sure that this should also perform well. The cooler that will handle our CPU is the ROG Ryujin 2 360mm AIO liquid cooler, which has a massive LCD panel on its CPU block that can be customized, and it also has a fan inside its CPU block for cooling your VRMs. While the black Noctua fans that come with the Ryujin 2 cooler would definitely perform better than any other fans that we may replace them with, we did use some RGB fans instead because Mama needs her RGB. We installed these FS120A white RGB fans from Frostec in front of the case, even though replacing the 3 140mm fans that come with the case is not really necessary as it does have RGB on its front panel, which we will check out. We were going to install a 2TB Gen 4 SSD in this, but that got stuck in customs, but it was added in post by my team of advanced visual effects editors. But we do have a 10TB WD Gold HDD, and this is actually real and we aren't using any visual effects here. For our GPU, we have the ROG Strix OC RTX 3080, which is very powerful without being stupidly expensive. It looks great and it also ran extremely cool and silent in my tests, even with higher clock speeds. We are going to install it vertically in our case because GPU shrouds don't deserve to be hidden, and we are obviously not using a Gen 5 riser cable here, but this shouldn't cause any issues. We are also going to install some custom sleeved cables from Sensei Mods in this matching white and light grey theme, but to add some more bling, we'll also use the Lianli Streamer Plus cable for our motherboard. The ROG Strix Helios has tons of space on the backside for cable management, but it also has this plastic door to hide them so it doesn't look bad with the tempered glass, but we were still able to do this easily and have a finished setup. And after instantly overheating the CPU because we didn't plug in the pump's micro USB port in its hub, we fixed some issues and were able to boot. So now let's see what the final result looks like. And I have to say that that is easily one of the best looking PCs that I have built, and I have built some real gems. The case and cooler are of course a big highlight of this special build, but it is the performance of the new Elder Lake CPU that is even more exciting. Now, I didn't get a lot of time to do a proper benchmarking and comparison with the Ryzen 9 5950X, but without even unlocking the power limits or overclocking the 12900K, we were able to get around a 20% faster result in the Cinebench R20 single core benchmark, which is really huge and something that I really wasn't expecting even knowing what Intel is capable of. The multi-core results were also similarly impressive, and I have to say that I was quite skeptical about this big little efficiency core thing in the 12900K, but it did deliver a multi-core score that is very similar to my 5950X, which I really wasn't expecting. Even though this was just one slightly older benchmark, I can see how this would put Intel ahead of AMD in gaming, and seeing a 24-thread CPU match their 32-thread processor is also really impressive. AMD is of course also going to be coming up with newer Ryzen CPUs, but one thing that is certain is that the next coming years are going to be very exciting, and this kind of competition is something that we'll be seeing after more than a decade, so as long as the global chip shortage doesn't cripple the availability, things are really going to be worth looking forward to. I am not including a price list today because I don't know what these components cost, but I will include links to these components in the video description when they become available, so you can check out what the current pricing is. So let me know your thoughts about this build and about the competition in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.